Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches. Director's Cut, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and I can't believe I totally spaced on what we would probably be using this key for. Ornate key? Heavily adorned? Going to the chapel. But we're not going to get married. Can't believe I forgot about that. Alright. I actually forgot how to get there. The crypt is through the side, so the crypt is through the side. So then the chapel. Is this way? Massive door is locked. The lock produced a loud noise that echoed in the quietness of the area. It made me wonder about the secrets that have been kept safe and undisturbed in here for years. Is not even inside the chapel did I perceive a peaceful environment. The deadly stillness was deeply unnerving. And loud. Is that an actual person hanging there? It sure looks like it. I guess our character doesn't have... doesn't see to remark on that yet. Okay. That's your basic religious photo. Painting. Was this when he was about to be put on the cross? Oh yeah, they got the cross, erecting the cross over there. Well, we can't walk this way, right? I'm really putting off going forward into the thing. We can go forward, or we can just go upstairs. I feel that would be silly to do. Oh, we can look at that. Yeah! We've got step-by-step instructions of how to nail Jesus to the cross. Follow these simple instructions. This guide will show you the way. I can't really look at that yet. It's too far away, I guess. It's not some kind of trap door there, is it? Anything on these pews? Please don't get on the cross, Jesus, please. Now I have to. It's for their sins. They know not what they do. Oh, I missed this one. Well, I missed a couple of them. Yep, there he is. All in place here. Seen that one. Alright, so it must go around. Yeah. It starts here and goes around. So there's nothing to look at from where we are. Can't go right over there, but that way. Is that made of wood? I can't look at it. It's like no description for it. Hmm. No, don't put the baby on the cross. I'll go on the cross. I don't want the baby on the cross. At this point, I wasn't going to bother with the light switches anymore. Yet, there I was, bothering with the light switch. I forgot all about this place. I'm a blasphemer. Well, look at that. It was some kind of small metal ring. We pull it, and this opens. Can't look at this stuff. The accoutrements inside the chapel, though mostly golden and shiny, looked sad and fragile. Bell. The chalice was lavish and pleasing to the eye, but was sadly of no use to me. And I just didn't... the plate or whatever either. Did I look at this one? Alright. On the cross he goes. Oh, accoutrements. Is that an actual candle? We finally find a candle. Brother. There was a large wooden statue of Christ looking after this holy place. I've always wondered what inri means. Oh, that's Latin, isn't it? Inri? I used to know what it meant. It's words in Latin, I think. Wait, can't type. Right. Jesus Nazarenus Rex, sorry, Rex Eodorum, meaning Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. But apparently there's more. Oh, generally thought of to consist of that. I'm in an opinion piece, so who knows? Oh. What is this? Could be in Rhode Island. Pontius Pilate's wife said that. Alright, that's a good enough explanation for me. Back to the task at hand. The statue had a noticeable orifice in the bottom. Huh. An orifice. Insert. Huh. I'll try a few things on this quote-unquote orifice. Sorry. I don't know why you would put it that way. The orifice did not need to be oiled. I've not used this knife for anything, I don't think. Unless it takes a key, I don't think it does. It will stop trying to shove things into the foot orifice. Alright, before we go pulling the metal ring, which is gonna lead to a hidden thing underneath, let's go look upstairs. The cabinet on this small loft contained items that seemed to have belonged to a priest. Holy Bible. The Bible and Holy Scriptures contained in the old Andrew, I think, Testament, translated, Accor, etc., with most profitable anota to the most virtuous and noble Queen Elizabeth. The name's in order of all the something epistle to our beloved in the Lord. Ah! Look at that! A hollowed out. That's awesome. I love that. That's used. We'll insert that. Oh, you know what? We hammer that through his foot. It's a symbolic thing. That goes in the quote unquote orifice. Very clever. That's that, okay. Don't ask me why I close things up again. Look at that. A circle. Coat rack or something. Yeah. Wait a second. Can I look at this now? No. Cobwebs. How tearful. Jesus comes to life and starts attacking us. It was a heavy nail and very cold to the touch. Do you have anything new to say? I'm finally inside the chapel, the place where Blackwood spent most of the time during his last days. I can feel it. I'm about to make great discoveries in here. Yeah, hopefully you don't end up dead in the process. We hammered it in. There's a nail inserted in the hole now. Everything still the same, kinda. So he's got. So does that mean we can pull this now? I mean, I was gonna pull it anyway. I didn't try pulling it from here. Oh, can't. Oh my God. Why can't we do anything from here? That's what I want to know. Okay, now what? This hasn't opened all the way. Check the front. Maybe there's something else, another thing I have to push or something. I don't see anything. See, there's a problem now because I can't interact with this at all. I can move back and forth. That's it. And I can't pull that back out. I thought I saw it change to a magnifying glass. Well, that's crazy. So what now? Getting like clueless here. I missed something. Well, they don't look shiny. This stuff looks shiny. So what about the ring? What if I light that candle? So I can't. Can't access the candle itself. Just the holder, but it just says I'm not a pyromaniac, which is a complete lie. I am becoming clueless. And by becoming, I mean past tense. Something was curiously different about the INRI sign now. Okay. I couldn't reach it. Can the crowbar reach it? Whoa. Really? Oh, we can go in there. Well, look at that. Can't look at them. Can't go forward. I could walk around to the other side, but I'm assuming it would be the same. Brother. Well, oh, we can't turn around here. Never mind. Huh? Here we got books. It was nearly impossible to discern anything in the secret room, but that seemed to be a candle. Second candle we've ever seen. This is how we came in. Oh boy, overlooking. That is so creepy. Got more books. Letters. We can't read this stuff. Can I step forward? You know what? We have to look at the candle first. Don't we? I mean, light it. Actually, I have a use for our matches again. Oh, look, we've got a map of Africa. Most of the books scattered in the hidden room were about occultism and African culture. Even their titles were disturbing. I took a branch. I'm gonna read that momentarily. The branch was very odd looking. Oh, it's on a crate, says from Africa as well. Strange titles such as De Vermis Mysteris gave me the shivers. As much as I love books, I didn't even dare to open those. Yeah, that's one of the books, like, along with the Necronomicon. That's, like, a fictional book, supposedly. The candle was now providing a gentle light. Well, at least something around here is gentle. Alright, let's look over here. That's the same. Okay. That's really it. April 5th, 1963. Christopher, these may very well be my last notes in this regard. I'm afraid Catherine has already realized what I've been doing here all the time. In vain, I've tried to explain myself, and I know what might have been the outcome had I kept insisting. If you could only believe me, Christopher, because I know you intend well, but I can feel the doubt in your heart. Put your rational thoughts aside for a moment and yield to the facts. If I can do it, someone who was constantly taught in the wonders of science ever since his childhood, then so can you. I'm hoping that you will contemplate the possibility of some truth in my assessments once you read about my latest findings. It is imperative that you carry on with this task. Catherine is watching my every step, and I'm afraid she'll take strong measures if I do anything out of the ordinary. Did you know she has been talking to other doctors besides you, and psychiatrists? Heaven forbid. My God, Christopher, I feel that she's willing to shut me up in a madhouse. Oh, yeah, for you. I thought you meant for herself. It could be for herself, and you're just being paranoid. How is it possible that all of you won't believe me, as if what happened with my own son wasn't enough proof? A curse? It's gotta be a curse. In my adjacent notes, you will find an exhaustive essay on the origin of the curse, there you go, and what should be done to eliminate it. I know the whole amulet deal must sound crazy, but you have to trust me. The tribe has been doing this for centuries. Are you going to forfeit all that knowledge and experience? They faced a god, Christopher, and lived to tell it. Now it's our turn to live and tell the story. And Christopher, if we fail to remove the curse and anything happens to me, I want you to do it. And I have my complete mental faculties whilst I'm asking you this. Yeah, but everyone who doesn't have their mental faculties thinks that they have their mental faculties. That's becoming more and more dangerous lately. Do not hesitate. There is simply no other way, and you would be the only one left who can do it. Promise me. Promise me you will. He can't. I guess he's gonna write you back. I know I'm asking you to become a cold-hearted murderer, but Christopher, our lives, and possibly many others are at stake. Isn't that enough to forget your vow? Is that his, doctor-patient confidentiality vow, or his, vow to help others type thing? March 26th. The folklore of the Dalmar is just as disturbing as their vicious attacks. If my researches have been correct, then I could have stumbled upon one of the most ancient tribes ever known to humanity, dating back to the era where the so-called Bushmen inhabited South Africa. We're talking over 20,000 years ago. How could any civilization manage to survive all this time without ever hunting or expanding, just being there? I don't dare to imagine what 200 centuries of inbreeding and cannibalism could do to people. I've seen them, and they can't be called humans. What is most unsettling is their mystical background, impossible to be considered a religion due to its complete lack of basic rules and maturity. The only simple premise is to keep an evil entity at bay, which has been stalking them, quote-unquote, since the beginning of time, or quote-unquote, dark ages. At this point in my research, I had to stop and consider the implications. The Dalmor actually thought of their later period, the systematic slaughtering of mankind, as good times or golden ages. I think the lore that this tribe never managed to grow, as I seriously think the region, maybe even the entire continent, would have suffered terrible consequences. This history is so ancient that it makes me feel dizzy. The vengeful god was, which is insane. Incidentally referred to as Dolum or Dothum. I guess it's Dothum? I mean Dolum? D-O-L-H-O-M? Would control the Dalmor via as many incarnations. Most of the time it would be a tall feline-like figure. Oh, a tall feline-like figure always dwelling in shadows and slaying any villager would unwittingly come close. Some say its deadly claws would not only penetrate your body, but your soul. The purpose of the harassment is unclear. It would look as if the Dalmor were simple toys to play with. It seems then that the Dalmor managed to free themselves from its clutches with the help of an amulet or charm, which would effectively force the entity to retreat. The most curious thing is how this amulet was conceived. The two main elements were required to perform the exorcising of this evil, and they had to be strictly related to each other, one representing the victim and the other representing the victimizer. To achieve this, something related to each one was used. Am I going to be making this thing? While I'm not sure what is referred to as the victim, I think it can be concluded that anything belonging to any villager would have served, given that they were all victims. As for something representing the victimizer, that may have been more complicated. What could possibly be related to a god? This god in question? Next, these elements had to be mixed with a rare medicinal plant native to the region, which apparently had the properties to blend both items together, as long as they were not too solid. Okay, I have the medicinal plant. Finally, a branch of a particular tree whose name escapes me now had to be used as the holder of the blended items. Okay, just got the branch. It is on this item that a mysterious blessing was performed. It should be noted that all the elements had to be organic. The Dalamora successfully released themselves from the control of the vicious god with an intense ritual that seems to have taken days to perform. In the end, the amulet was so powerful that the entity surrendered to their will and offered divine power in exchange for sacrifices. But the Dalamora wouldn't allow to be fooled. They decided that getting rid of this evil once and for all would be the wisest thing to do, so they managed to capture its spirit and store it someplace where they could guard it for ages to come. Oh, the last part. My God! The evil spirit was cast into a mass, trapped inside the confines of its blessed wood for eternity. A mask which its description bears uncanny resemblance to... Who am I fooling? It is that mask. The Dalamora would keep the spirit at bay via regular rituals involving the bloody sacrifices and the aforementioned amulet. The last book I read today about the Dalamora, in reality two small paragraphs as amusing bonus reading in a book lent by the museum, has revealed to me something that left me completely paralyzed with terror. I've always wondered, since I began studying them, what made the Dalamora savagely slaughter neighboring tribes without any apparent reason. Was it a violent, raw instinct? Did they feel threatened in any way? Was it by a perverse and ungodly sense of enjoyment? No, it was fear. Fear that someone else would take the mask and release the god. They killed to protect themselves from falling again into the Dark Ages. If they went to such extreme lengths to avoid this, then what did they have to endure when the entity was free? The rituals haven't been performed on the mask for years now. What have I done? I was shocked to learn about this evil. Terrible as it was, I still wondered to what extent James Blackwood went to get rid of the curse. Can't read that stuff. So this goes on the on here. Oh no. Looks like I can look at that, but I can't look at that. That's kind of crazy. Well, the chapel. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Actually, let me read this first. The story is fully revealed to me now. That disturbing African mask is cursed. It isn't exactly important whether this curse is real or not, even though I'm actually willing to believe that due to my experiences inside this house. But the fact is that Blackwood believed it was very real. What drastic measures did he take to get rid of it? A murder? A sacrifice? Both? Best of both worlds? Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.